Oh, howdy all, grab yourself a drink, it is time for some Path of Exile discussion. The Necropolis expansion provides a pretty powerful crafting mechanism. This is something that's been explored a fair bit at the high end of crafting, and it's extremely, extremely powerful at said high end of crafting. What I wanted to do though today is put out a bit of a guide to making really, really good gear on a budget. This is not going to be a 100% deterministic craft. We're not necessarily going to succeed, but we've got a good chance. The odds are stacked in our favour. So in editing, I thought I would add a little comment here that I got fairly lucky in this video. You'll notice that I do hit the 6-link craft, which I think to be about a 70% chance. So the odds are in my favour, but they're definitely not guaranteed. And additionally, I also hit very high tiers on the energy shield mods. I do get the 3 mods that I want. The odds are definitely biased in my favour on that. But then when it comes to the tiers, I only ban tiers 4 through 11 of flat energy shield. And I only ban tiers 3 through 8, not tiers 2 through 8 of the percentage ES, and I only ban tiers 3 through 6 of the hybrid ES, yet I manage to roll really high on those. So do keep that in mind. Most people who follow through on the craft will get something that is in the roll range they outlined on the thumbnail, so 600 to 800, but getting 762 and also getting 90 points of resistances, that's at the luckier end of what could be expected. I'd say that what you see here is about a 10th percentile outcome for this crafting method. Our goal here is going to be to craft a roughly 600 energy shield Vaal Regalia that will also have high tier resistances on it. We will probably get 2 high tier resistances, although that can't be guaranteed. Additionally, using fairly rare crafts, you can deterministically 6-link the item output. We're actually not going to go that route. Instead, we're going to go with the probabilistic approach, which is going to use much less precious crafts than the 6-link one, because I want this to be things that you're likely to find yourself on your pathway to about level 90 in the current league. So we have an enormous, enormous amount of corpses. And what we're gonna do is just simply add them all into the Necropolis mortuary. This is quite a clunky interface and I really don't find it particularly enjoyable to use, but that's a rant for another day. I'm only going to use one of these meta corpses, the ones that increase the effect of adjacent humanoid corpses. So I'm gonna drop one of these down here. And then in the surrounding locations, we're going to put down reforged socket links and reforged socket numbers, which is some of the things that we do want to get an increase of here. So we're going to drop these in. This is more to showcase this mechanic as it's something that is more at home in a more advanced craft. So reforged socket links 200 times. And we will also put 500% increased chance of defense modifiers and 50 to modifier tier rating using up some of those humanoid corpses. So this one says 40% increased effect of humanoid corpses adjacent to the corpse. These ones are all adjacent, so they get that buff. Now, what we're going to do is drop in all of the other corpses that we've prepared. The easiest way to showcase this is actually for me to just place them all and then show you the final result when we're done. There will be one more step after that, but we need to make sure that they're all in a contiguous blob. If they're not all connected to each other, then you'll end up that you'll craft only the ones that are connected. So we need to make sure that everything is connected, although we will be able to confirm that before we go ahead. You'll see that we're increasing the chances of defense modifiers, increasing the chances of resistance modifiers, and then perhaps paradoxically, we are decreasing the chances of getting life modifiers. This is a very, very, very deliberate choice. What we're doing with those life modifiers is trying to reduce the weakest of the energy shield mods' chance to spawn. Now we have a whole bunch of things here where we're reforging socket numbers 200 times, and taking the best outcome, and doing the same with links as well. Our goal here is that we're trying to make a 6-link. This is not deterministic, but like I said, I don't want to use any genuinely rare crafting reagents that you might not find yourself, because I want this to be something people can realistically replicate in solo self-found without being lucky. The only thing that you might not find in SSF, this is a fairly rare one. This mimics the effect of a sacred orb and does so 6 times on the armor. I'm going to use that anyway, but it's not something that you can't do this craft without. So we're now going to put in these last ones and then we'll be good to go. Then we'll explain exactly what the goal is once we start the crafting process. So we'll open the Tome of Aramor and here you'll see what we're doing. Plus 30 to quality up to a hard cap of 30%. So this means that we are going to get a 30 quality Vaal Regalia out of this. Reforge socket numbers and links an enormous number of times. This gives us a very good chance, not a promise, but a very good chance of getting a 6-link item. There's that Sacred Orb mod, but then we have the really important stuff. Plus 2 explicit modifiers. By default, any Gravecraft in the normal game is going to have 4 mods, and in the Ruthless version is going to have 1. These plus explicit modifier crafts are extremely important. For most beginner crafts, you want to make a 6 mod item, although there are definitely some exceptions where you'll be fine making a 5 mod item. We are massively, massively biasing mods in favor of defense mods and in favor of resistance modifiers. This is because we want this to have maximum ES, and that means that we want to have flat ES, we want to have percentage ES, and we want to have one of the hybrid energy shield rolls. What we don't want though is to hit both of them, and for that reason we are nerfing the chances of getting life modifiers through the use of those life modifiers are 300% scarcer craft. And then the most important thing, plus to modifier tier rating. I have put in 6 of these crafts. One of them is actually buffed by 40% because I was demonstrating that metacraft. This bans the lowest 77% of modifier tiers, which means that we're going to be biased heavily towards the highest possible tiers of mods. The more modifier tier rating you can get, the better your outcome will be. And now the next thing we need to do once we select armor and then go body armor and choose a pure intelligence one, so that is pure energy shield and select Vaal Regalia, we're going to get one last chance to look at things, and there's something very important you'll need to see here. I've held off on this last step. You'll notice that this is item level 82. At this point we want to cancel it because chest armor really wants to be item level 86, and I can get that to item level 86. All I need to do is get a number of the corpses that say +1 to item level. And I'm going to need exactly 4 of these, after which I'll reassess. I don't actually know what the formula is that determines the exact item level that's created. All I know is that it is heavily dependent upon the input item levels that you're using. I kind of suspect that it is the average of the item levels of the inputs +3, with a hard cap of the highest item level corpse that you put in, but I'm not absolutely certain of that. Whatever the case, we'll definitely bring that up by the use of 2 additional corpses, which again need to be placed in contiguous plots for this to work. Now, we can reopen the Tome of Aramor and then recheck. We've got +4 to item level, which we didn't have before. Body armor, energy shield, Vaal Regalia, make certain. This is item level 86 and explicit modifiers are 6. So, let's see what we get. Note that I have used absolutely no precious crafts in this process. Everything I've used has been something easily replaced. And that's actually better than I was expecting. We've got the Unfaltering mod, 108% increased energy shield. We've got Seraphims, tier 1, 41% increased ES. We've got Incandescent, which is 81 on a scale from 77 to 90. That's actually a fair bit off perfect. Then we got 2 excellent resistances, 44 to lightning and 46 to cold. And we got the Ob Second Wind suffix, which was fairly likely to spawn. Isn't really what we'd like. Ideally, we would get fire resistance in that place, but it's certainly something you're happy to see. So, this is a budget-friendly craft. This used absolutely no precious crafts in order to do this. All we did was we used a bunch of things that can be purchased in bulk, or that you're likely to find yourself while you're playing the game. That's some of the power of Necropolis crafting if you are not playing at the top end of progression. If you're playing at the top end of progression, there's plenty of guides out there for crafting +2 scepters, or crafting things with 3 fractured modifiers on them, which can be incredibly, incredibly strong. But I'm going to leave it there. May your Vaal Regalias be crafted in interesting ways.